Welcome to the course Introduction to R Programming. In this lecture, we will continue with statistical functions, central tendency and variation. In our previous lecture, we discussed about various statistical functions, descriptive statistics, in that absolute and relative frequencies. Then continuation of statistical functions. So again here we will review other descriptive statistics. Here mainly we will concentrate on the two statistical functions, central tendency of the data, then variability. Now we will see one by one. You can recall once in descriptive statistics, we mentioned in our earlier lecture, primary tools which gives the first-hand information. We have two major tools, central tendency of data, variation in data. In central tendency of data, the following are the measures. The first one is mean, then median, then mode, then geometric mean, then harmonic mean, etc. All these measures which are used to represent central tendency of data. Then coming to variation in data, the following are the measures related to variation in data. The first one is variance, second one standard deviation, then third one standard error, then fourth one mean deviation, etc. Now all these central tendency of data and variation in data, the following measures we will demonstrate here with examples and implementation using R software. So then coming to central tendency of data. First of all, what is use of this one? Gives an idea about the mean value of the data. Here data is clustered around what value? That value is identified here. So let us take data x1, x2 and so on xn, where x is data vector. With this data, now we will see one by one what are the measures, the basic formulas. Then using R, how that can be implemented. The first one, mean, also called as arithmetic mean. The formula is denoted by x bar equal to 1 by n summation sigma I equal to 1 to n xi based on the given number of observations n. So if n equal to 5, so it takes sum of x1 plus x2 plus x3 and so on, whole divided by 5. So that is the formula for calculating mean or arithmetic mean. Syntax used in R software. Simply you can use mean within parentheses, the name of the function or vector, mean of x. With this, we can execute the mean function. Then we'll see the results. Similarly, next one, geometric mean. So geometric mean denoted by x bar suffix gm. Gm stands for geometric mean. So here this can be obtained by product of xi with the whole power 1 by n. So pi from I equal to 1 to n xi whole power 1 by n. This is the formula for geometric mean. So the equivalent syntax in R is product of x power 1 by length of x. This is the equivalent syntax for calculating geometric mean. Here length of x is equal to the number of elements in x. Wherever geometric mean you need to find it, use this syntax. Next measure, harmonic mean, which is denoted by x bar suffix hm. Hm stands for harmonic mean, which is defined as 1 by, then 1 by n sigma I equal to 1 to n 1 by xi. So this is the formula for harmonic mean. The equivalent syntax in R is 1 by mean of 1 by x, whatever the vector x. So using this formula, we will calculate harmonic mean. Now coming to median. What is median? Is a value such that the number of observations above it is equal to the number of observations below it. So it takes top and bottom. The number of observations above the top is equal to the number of observations below the top. The syntax is simply by using the function median. Median within parentheses, you can call the data vector. Let us take it as x, median of x. Then coming to examples. So let us take one data vector, numeric vector. All these you can apply for numerical values. So let us take marks equal to some student's marks can be taken as the vector C of so and so. Then those can be stored in the name marks. Then you can call marks so that all marks will be displayed. Now for the marks vector, you can apply all the central tendency of data measures. Now arithmetic mean, the formula is simply by using the function mean in R software. Mean of the vector name is marks. So now it calculates the arithmetic mean of all the marks stored in the vector marks. Then geometric mean, the R syntax is product of marks power 1 by length of marks. Then the result is this one, 59.88082. Similarly, harmonic mean, the formula is 1 divided by mean of 1 by marks. See, first it calculates 1 by marks. For that, mean will be calculated for this 1 divided by the final result. So then this is the final outcome. Similarly, median, we will use simply median of marks. So directly it calculates the median value. Now we will demonstrate one by one. So open our software. Then so before executing, all of you copy these commands in a notepad. Then it is easy for you for execution. Now first I am creating a vector marks. Now you can call marks. Yeah, the vector marks are displayed. Now the functions one by one you can calculate. First arithmetic mean. The formula for arithmetic mean or mean is simply mean. So here vector name is marks. So now you will get the arithmetic mean of all these numerical values presented in the vector marks. So mean of the vector data vector name marks. So next one, geometric mean. The formula is product of marks power 1 by length of marks. So use this formula to calculate geometric mean. Now you can see this is the result will get. Then next one, harmonic mean. The formula for harmonic mean is 1 divided by mean of 1 by marks. Now you can see this is the result. So for all these measures, compulsory you need to take numeric vector only, because these are statistical measures, so works on only numerical. Then median, another one. So simply you can take using the function median of marks. So these are all the four measures what we demonstrated: mean, geometric mean, then harmonic mean, then median. Yeah, this is the output what we demonstrated. Then coming to some of the things we can't do. So mean function we can't use like this. So mean of direct values we can't enter. Suppose here mean of 1, 2, 3, 4. Here error, invalid use argument. It calculates mean for only by default first value. But exact mean value we can't obtain here using this one. So multiple values inside the mean function can be combined using the combined function C. C of 1, 2, 3, 4. Then it creates a vector with 1, 2, 3, 4. Then for that vector, the mean function is applied. 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 divided by total number. So 4. How many observations? 4 observations. So you will get. So this is the note you have to remember. So we can't take mean values directly using the mean function. So using C only you can combine. So whenever you can execute these two, see the difference. You will also see. So mean of direct values you are giving. It takes only default one, the first value. It won't take all. So if you want to compute mean for all the values, then you can create it as a vector by using C of. Now you can see. So 2.5 is the exact mean of all the observations. Then coming to second part, variability. Previously, whatever we discussed, those are all central tendency of data. Now the second statistical function, variability. So here, spread and scatteredness of data around any point, preferably the mean value. So let us take two different data sets. First data set consisting of, let us take 360, 370, 380. So the mean of these three observations is calculated by using the formula mean equal to sum of all individual observations divided by total observations. 360 plus 370 plus 380 whole divided by 3, you will get 370 as the mean value. Then another data set, you can see your data set 10, 100, 1000, its mean is 10 plus 100 plus 1000 by 3, you will get 370. Here you can observe the two data sets, we are producing the same mean value, but how to differentiate between the two data sets? For that we will use variability. Here the data sets are different, but outcome is same. Using the variability, variance, by calculating variance. So we will differentiate such type of data sets. So the first measure related to variability is variance. The formula for variance in mathematics, variance of the data vector x equal to 1 by n sigma summation I equal to 1 to n xi minus x bar whole square. Here x bar is the mean value, then xi depends on number of observations, I equal to 1 to n, x1, x2, and so on. Then the equivalent syntax in R by using the function var of the data vector x. So var of x, x is a data vector. Directly, this formula is implemented in this function. That is the variance. Then another one, standard deviation is another variability function. So what is standard deviation? Positive square root of variance. This can be denoted in R using the function sqrt of variance of x. That means for the variance function, you are applying square root. That it takes only positive square root. Then that is called a standard deviation, where x is data vector. Then there is another variant of variance. So using this formula, variance of x equal to 1 by n minus 1 into sigma I equal to 1 to n xi minus x bar whole square by using n minus 1, 1 by n minus 1. This is another variant of variance. Here if we want to divisor to be n, then we use this one. N minus 1 divided by n, this will be within parentheses into variance of x. So here n equal to length of x, the total number of observations in x. So this is another variant of variance. Then another variability function is range function. So the range function will be calculated using the following formula: maximum of the data variables x1, x2, and so on, xn, minus minimum of x1, x2, and so on, xn observations. So n observations are given, x1 to xn are n observations. So maximum of n observations minus minimum of n observations. The equivalent syntax in R is by using max function, max of x minus min of x. Directly by using this, you can find out the range. Then another function related to variability, interquartile range. So interquartile range, abbreviated as IQR, this can be calculated by using the formula: third quartile of the observations minus first quartile of all the observations. That is, third quartile of the observations are x1, x2, and so on, xn, minus first quartile of the observations are x1, x2, and so on, xn. So the equivalent syntax in R, simply you can use all uppercase letters, I, Q, R of the vector x. So inter quartile range by using simply IQR. Then quartile deviation, this can be calculated using the following formula: by using previous formula, third quartile of all the observations x1 to xn minus first quartile of all the observations x1 to xn whole divided by 2. So this formula inside the parenthesis is nothing but interquartile range. So interquartile range by 2, this is nothing but quartile deviation. The equivalent syntax in R is IQR of x whole divided by 2, that is quartile deviation. Then another one, mean deviation, which is abbreviated as MD of the data vector x, equal to 1 by n sigma I equal to 1 to n mod xi minus x bar. X bar is the mean. So the absolute value, summation of the absolute values whole divided by n. The equivalent syntax in R is using sum function, sum within parentheses, by using absolute function ABS within parentheses x minus mean of x whole divided by length of x. This is the syntax for mean deviation, which is part of variability. Then again take the same data vector marks. Now you can apply all these variability measures and observe the results. So first variance, simply you can use VAR of marks. This is the result. You can calculate manually and compare with this also. Then standard deviation, that is absolute square root of variance, SQRT of variance of marks, that is standard deviation. Now these two first you can execute, then we will see the remaining variance and standard deviation by using square root of variance. Now we already created the marks vector, so now you can clear and run freshly. So this is the marks vector. So now first we are applying variance of marks. Now you can see this is the outcome. Similarly, standard deviation, that is SQRT of variance of marks. Now you can see this is the outcome. Then coming to next one, interquartile range, simply by using IQR, all uppercase letters, of the vector name marks. Then quartile division, IQR of marks by 2. Then you will get 16.75 as the result. Now run these two commands. So here, capital letters, IQR of the vector name is marks, that is interquartile range. Then another one, So quartile deviation. So here IQR of marks by 2. So this is quartile deviation. Yeah, these are all the outputs we obtained. Like you can take your own data vector. You can apply all these central tendency and variability measures. Then coming to mean deviation, the formula is sum of absolute of marks minus mean of marks whole divided by length of marks. Then you will get the mean deviation for the same vector marks. This is the output we will obtain. So copy this command. This command is very lengthy. We already copied here. So sum of absolute of marks minus mean of marks whole divided by length of marks. Now you can see this is the output of this mean deviation measure. Yeah, you can recall our variability measures here, that is variance, then standard deviation, square root of, then IQR, interquartile range, IQR deviation, then mean deviation, sum of all the measures at one screenshot. Here you can see the results on the data set marks. So then coming to here, we consider two data sets, different data sets, but producing the same mean value. So how that can be handled? Spread and scatterness of data around any point, preferably the mean value. The data set one, what we have considered, 360, 370, 380. Its mean value is calculated using this formula. Then its variability you can calculate. Then you will see the differentiation between the two data sets. You can apply variance VAR, use the vector C of 360, 370, 380. So here the variance is 100. While coming to mean, you are getting same mean value for both data sets. But how to differentiate by using variance? So here variance is 100 for this data set. Then second data set 10, 100, 1000, which mean is same, but you can calculate its variance. Here you can see variance of C of, you can see the difference. So in the previous, the variance is 100. Here the variance is 299,700. Like that, using variability, we will distinguish. Now we will also demonstrate this one. The first one, variance of C of 360, 370, 380. See, 100 is the variance. Then second data set, what we have taken, 10, 100, 1000. See its variance, 299,700. So like this, we will find out the variability of different data sets, even producing the same mean value. Here also some observations you need to remember. So whenever you can execute the command variance with all the values directly, it shows error. Even in case of mean, by default, the first value mean is calculated, but in the variance, it is not like that. Error in variance, invalid use argument. Compulsory we have to use variance of C of command function vector. Now we'll also try this one. So whenever you can use variance inside a variance function, directly if we can give the values, it shows error. If mean means, at least by default first value, it calculates mean. But variance won't work. Compulsory, you have to combine all the multiple values using a combined function. Now you can see this is the variance. So these important observations we have to remember in variance and mean. Okay, that's all about this lecture, central tendency and variation. Now coming to conclusion, we have learned how to measure the central tendency of the data and how to measure the variation in the data using some popular functions. And you need not to write any individual program to write on these quantiles, quantities. But our base function is giving all these functions directly. they are the built-in functions, and that is the advantage of using R here, so that you can compute all these values directly without any trouble. So I would request you that you please try to do some practice using some other data sets, then only you will get the clear picture of all these central tendency and variations of data. And we will see you in the next lecture with some more topics. Till then, goodbye. Happy learning.